Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to configure disks and volumes in Windows Server 2016. This task is very similar to Lab 3 of Microsoft Official Academic Course, Installation, Storage and Compute with Windows Server 2016, Lab Manual, Exam 70-740. First I will install Windows Server Core in Hyper-V. Then I will configure disks and volumes, manage NTFS and share permissions, create, configure and mount VHDs, and finally I will clean up by resetting the server so that I can perform more lab exercises. The virtualization support that is Intel VTX or AMD V may be disabled by default. To be able to use Hyper-V and create virtual machine in a Hyper-V, I need to make sure that the Intel VTX or AMD V is enabled. First, I will install the Hyper-V role in Windows Server through the Add Roles and Features wizard of the Server Manager. So the Hyper-V role has been added. Now I'm going to restart the machine. Now from the server manager, I run the Hyper-V manager. Then I'm going to create a new virtual machine where I will install Windows Server 2016 Core Edition. I'm mounting the Windows Server 2016 installer ISO image so that the installation starts when the virtual machine reboots. So the virtual machine has been created. I'm going to power it on and the installation should start. The installation process has started and I will go through the wizard. Here in the Select Operating System window, I have both the Core Edition and the Desktop Edition, which comes with graphical user interface. The Core Edition doesn't have a graphical user interface and it is command controlled. It performs better than the Desktop Edition as it doesn't load a lot of components that the Desktop Edition does. So I finished the rest of the setup wizard. The machine will restart after the installation is complete. The server asks to change the password and I set a new password. So it comes to the command line and the installation is complete. Now I'm going to configure the server by using sconfig command. Here I have different options. I enable the remote desktop. Finally, I shut down the machine. So I have installed the core edition of Windows Server 2016 in Hyper-V and enabled remote desktop. I'm logged into server 4. I right click on start button and choose disk management. Then from the action menu, I choose rescan disks. Then I right click on the first offline disk, which is disk 1, and choose online. Then I right click on disk 1, which is not initialized, and choose initialize disk. At the pop-up, I choose OK. Then I right click on the unallocated space of the disk and choose new simple volume. On the new volume wizard, I click next, 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 and at the volume level, I type data and click next. Finally, I click finish and the simple volume has been created. I will create a new user, create a new folder, and give permissions on that folder for the new user and check effective permission. I am at a domain controller. From the server manager, I go to the tools menu and then open Active Directory users and computers. I expand the domain and then I right click on the users and select new. I type in that user first name, last name, and logon name. Then I create a password for the user and check out user must change password at next logon option and check in password never expires. The user has been created. I close Active Directory users and computers. Next, from the file explorer, I create a new folder, right click on the new folder and go to the sharing tab. From the advanced sharing, I select share this folder. Then I go to permissions and select full control for everyone. Then press OK and OK again. Then I go to security tab and then go to advanced. Then check effective access for the new user on that folder. I select user and type in the username, click on check names and it will bring up the account. And I press OK. Now I check the effective access. I slide down and realize that even though full control has been applied in the share permission to all users, this user is not getting full control. This is because of the restrictions in NTFS permission. Now I go back and edit permission in the security tab. And then I select add, find the user. After the user was found, I select OK and give full control. And then apply and OK. Now I go back and check effective access for this user. And I can see that the user got full access. When you give share permission and NTFS permission on a folder, the effective access becomes the more restrictive one between the two when you try to access the folder over the network. If you access the folder locally on the computer, then NTFS permissions apply. In this exercise, I will create a virtual disk and mount the disk using computer management. On server 4, I start disk management. Then from the action menu, I create VHD. On the dialog box in the location text box, I type a name for the virtual disk. Then in the disk size text box, I select 5 GB and then I select VHDX option and press OK. Then I right click on the new disk and choose initialize disk from the context menu. And press OK. Then I right click on the unallocated space and choose new simple volume. I go through the new simple volume wizard with default values, give a volume label and finish the wizard. I can unmount the drive by right clicking on the disk and choosing detach VHD. I hope you found this video helpful. If you like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Thank you for watching.